lately.
We'll fade out this awesome reggae, hip-hop, whatever, reggaetron remix here. And I wanted to show you guys this video. So it's a 5-minute video, and we're gonna watch it together. So I'm gonna get this full screen for you, or not. I think that's about right. Looks like the audio's having a little issue, probably because I turned that down. Boom. All right, let's start that over.
Dear God, we thank you so much. We thank you for Meredith and just how she's been our life lately. Thank you for Anna, just what the wonderful wife she is and has been to me for the last 6 years. And I just love them both so much. And you know, amen. Okay. Hi. So we want to get together because we haven't had a monthly meeting, first of all. True. You originally came and we're going to let you live here for 6 months, right? Mm-hmm. And so I guess there's been kind of a difficult 2 or 3 weeks, to say the least, stretch us all pretty thin. And I guess ever since about 2 weeks in when you moved in here, mm-hmm. Well, obviously I haven't known you as well as Anna has over the last 4 or 5 years, yeah. But the Lord has just put it on my heart. And he's just given me a love for you. And he has shown me sides of you that I've never known before. And I just want you to know that you're probably one of the most gifted, talented people that I've ever seen. You know, you're brilliant and you're athletic and you play instruments and you speak other languages. And, And you take great care of our babies. And I just want you to know that you are so valuable. And regardless of what the enemy tells you, you are so worth everything. And when God created you before the earth, or he planned on creating you before the earth, and knowing how awesome you were going to be, and how wonderful you're going to be, First Kingdom. And I just want you to know that we love you so much. And I want you to know that in 6 months we still may make you move out. But we want this to be permanent, and we want to adopt you into our family. So we wanted to give you a forever family. We love you so much. And you have been loved and protected and taken care of like you should be. And we're gonna take care of you forever and protect you and love you, and you can just have security and know that we're always gonna be here for you, okay? This isn't gonna end in 6 months. We're always gonna be here for you, okay? You went from being an only child to having 2 siblings now. So
it's tough with at least one brother and sister, maybe more.
Probably a lot more. We love you so much, man. And you are so valuable. And I'm sorry that you've gone through all the hurt you have. And I'm sorry we couldn't protect you from it. But we can now, and we will. And you will always have somebody to take care of you, okay?
So, the reason I wanted to share that video with you guys today, a really good friend of mine posted that on Facebook, and it just kind of reminded me of some statistics I've heard in the past, and so I actually pulled up some of those, and this is from obafun.wordpress, so maybe not the most legitimate source in the whole wide world, but it's in it gives about the same facts that I've heard in the past, and the question that they raised, actually, and I'll put it up here for you, is how many Christians would it take to adopt all of the adoptable orphans in the world? So the questions you need to ask are, how many adoptable orphans are there in the world? How many Christians are there? And what is the percentage of Christians would it take to adopt all of the orphans? So my best guess, looking at the data available, see my orphan statistics post, is that 40 to 50 million orphans worldwide are adoptable, or would be best cared for through adoption. Ideally, that means adoption locally and indigenously first, and then adoption internationally. As for Christians, according to Mission Frontiers, globally there are about 800 million Christian believers who have been born again into a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Other Christians, 1.37 billion, who consider themselves Christian because they come from a Christian culture, and then culturally near non-Christians, 1.8 billion, are not yet Christians, but live in a people where a viable indigenous church movement has been established. So therefore, if roughly 6% of the born-again Christians in the world adopted, we could care for all of the adopted orphans in the world. I've heard 7% used, and that might be true as well. I've actually personally heard 10% myself. Either way you add it up, there are way too many orphans worldwide and way too many Christians to not believe we can make a difference. So that was kind of the thing I wanted to present tonight for a little bit of a precursor topic. Just something to at least plan it in your mind if that's something you would ever even consider about doing. I know not everybody's called to, but 6 to 10%, that's all it would take, and there would be no orphans in the world at all. And I know of a lot of Christians worldwide who are doing awesome work caring for orphans. And there's a lot of people like Meredith here who need a forever home and a forever family. And so there's always people looking for babies and young children, but it's the older kids that get neglected and the older kids who never really end up finding a place, and the older kids, or kids who stay together, have lower chances of being adopted as well. And so I just wanted to make you guys aware of some of those statistics and some of that before I jump into our playing of Outlast tonight. So thanks for sharing in with me on that little bit. And in response to Royal X-King, I definitely know that there are demonic strongholds all over the world, but and I've seen many of them myself, but I do not choose to give them any power. I don't acknowledge them, and instead of, I've personally found that the best way to fight against evil is to release love, and that's something I sincerely believe. And I mean, I believe that all heaven on earth has been, and all authority has been given to the name of Jesus Christ, and so that's something I will never back down from. I've had my fair share of spiritual warfare, and I know it's around us all the time.